Welcome back. She is the contestant who is as sweet as the dishes she created. But sadly, last night, Tamara was eliminated from MasterChef. But she is with us this morning. Welcome to the show. Now, you made it to the final four on MasterChef.
Yep.
That is a huge achievement. You must be very proud of yourself.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely no regrets. Much further than I thought I would go. I was happy at top 50. I was happy to get an apron. Aww. Happy not to be the first to go home. And, yeah, made it all the way to finals, especially after being eliminated. It was massive.
I was going to say, that's the great thing. You fought your way to get to top four.
Yeah.
Wasn't it an easy ride for you?
No, it definitely wasn't cruisy whatsoever. It was an absolute roller coaster, but that's not what we were there for. It was, you know, to build that resilience, and I'll take that with me.
Yeah, sure.
Do you know, when I've had a bit of a loss, I like to indulge in chocolate, and you're making some excellent desserts today.
Wow, look at this.
Three desserts.
Yeah, well, they say redemption is sweet. I was eliminated on a brownie, so I brought a brownie back. So
yes.
This time I've cooked it in advance, a little bit of a cheat. I've made sure it's...
I was going to say, is it cooked all the way through? Yeah.
Well, where do we start, darling?
Yeah, so I'm just going to heat up some cream. So I'm doing chocolate three different ways. Chocolate, chocolate, chocolate. I'm doing some chocolate ganache, which we're going to serve with the brownie. Doing some chocolate sauce and also some chocolate twigs, which is a little bit of an unknown factor. The last time I tried it, did end up with chocolate everywhere.
So okay. Heat her
fingers
up.
Crossed. Let's go.
I love being pregnant and working on this show. Now, you actually don't even have a sweet tooth. You don't like kind of desserts that much.
Yeah, look, I don't really have a massive sweet tooth, but I love making sweets for others, so... Yeah, I think that's what cooking's all about, kind of sharing your love and passion with others. So that's what I enjoy.
So we get that going.
There's lots to go around.
So you just put some thickened cream in the saucepan. And
yeah,
then
so
what
I
next?
Just wanted to show how simple, you know, two ingredients can be. So chocolate and cream in different ratios. So two parts chocolate, one part cream gives you that really fudgy ganache that you can also use for truffles.
How much do I heat this for?
Yes, so just until it's almost about to boil.
Okay.
Yeah, so you just watch that.
All right. What's it?
And should that boil?
It shouldn't boil so much too pressure. Much. It okay. shouldn't be scalding.
What do you mean too much? What's boiling too much?
You're doing a brilliant job.
Okay.
Just keep going.
Thank you.
Okay, so that kind of that bubbles and then you melt.
Yeah, so essentially what you need to do is have unmelted chocolate. Mm-hmm. You add the hot cream and that ensures it doesn't seize up, it doesn't split. And then you just stir that in until it's all melted.
Okay.
And you end up with, fudgy chocolate ganache.
Okay, and then once and you've got that ganache, sauce. What do you do with it? Besides
well,
eat it
I've
out
just quenelled it straight like that.
Do we,
but you can also roll it in some cocoa powder, some sprinkles, make some truffles.
Such a good point. Doesn't everyone just eat it out of the bowl?
Yes.
Yeah, look, if you do get
does
lazy,
it ever get
you can
to
go
this?
The just... solid ratio of just chocolate.
Yeah.
So how would you then put together, one of the chocolate ball things?
Nothing happening yet. I'm just on cream watch.
All right, yep.
Nothing happening.
Yep, good work.
Updates.
Thank you. So you just really just get a spoon of this, just dip it into a bowl of cocoa.
Can we do it?
Yeah,
can we do it?
Sure.
Wait, how much? This much?
Oh, yeah.
It's quite thick.
Yeah, that's
and
gigantic,
then just dip it
but
in.
That's amazing.
Oh, it's a bit...
Yep.
All right. Roll it in a ball.
Yep. You might get a little bit dirty, but that's okay.
That's all right.
Did you
or
wash your hands?
Chocolate.
Did you wash your hands?
I think you'd eat it.
And then this is cocoa powder?
Yep.
Powder?
Yep. Just
it's smoking! Sorry.
Oh, thank you.
Sorry, I just panicked
thanks
a little
so
bit.
Much.
I'm not sure. I don't know. It's smoking. We didn't
We're
talk
really
about it.
We're well under pressure.
Not really. My palms are wet. There's bubbles. Are they
all
too
right.
many bubbles?
That looks good. See? Hey, look at that. Yeah.
So I'm just going to demonstrate.
Oh, yours is
so
the same.
I'm just pouring some of this cream into...
Was that enough bubbles? Was that the right amount?
That was perfect. Oh, you did a spectacular job.
I did a spectacular job.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
All right. So
I watched it boil.
So essentially what you do is just mix this.
Oh, so you don't melt the chocolate, you just melt the butter too.
You
sorry,
melt
the cream.
Yeah,
okay.
That's right. So definitely don't melt chocolate first, otherwise it will seize up.
Okay.
Chocolate is a little bit temperamental.
Mm.
Yeah.
But if you do completely mess it up, you can always use the chocolate in a brownie recipe or, you know, it's always still good to eat.
Yeah,
let's be honest.
Mm.
And let's try some chocolate twigs. This is going to be the complicated
yeah,
part.
Yeah, sure.
So
okay.
If you want to hold this bag.
Oh, God. All right. I'm on a roll.
Yeah.
Why not?
So you just have to stand still again.
Yes.
Yep, that's it. Done.
All right.
Thank you. Just stay steady.
Small wins are still wins.
All right. We've got this. Just don't move or we'll end up with a little bit of a mess.
Can't talk. Don't know if that's, don't know if that's part of moving.
I don't want to distract you, but all right.
Thank you.
Brilliant job.
I got one supporter there who's just going, this guy can't even stand still. Oh, look, it's become a thing.
Yes, a pipe.
Pipe.
So just get a piping bag. If you don't have piping bags lying around, use a, you know, Glad bag, seal bag.
Okay.
Yeah. Yep. So just cut a little bit of it off.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. With these scissors. There we go.
Yep, hold on.
Okay. Now, all you do...
Oh. So this is a bucket of ice water.
Ooh, you're just doing quick lines across there. And then...
Yeah, okay. And then that will set in this iced water.
Yeah.
And essentially give us chocolate twigs, so...
Oh.
Isn't that clever?
I think we stumbled on something I could do as well. That's probably not as good.
You know, a little bit fun to do with kids and...
Yeah.
A little bit messy, but, you know.
And how long will that take to set up?
So it's almost set now, so...
Wow.
Yeah. Then we just drain it off, essentially, and it's ready to
serve.
Can we
pick one up?
Yeah, we'll try and pick one up. Yep.
Oh, how cool is that?
Oh, that's just the most... Wow.
So we'll set these aside on there just to drain.
Wow.
That's so many things you can use that for decoration, for all sorts of stuff.
Yeah, it's just a little bit of, you know, fancy plating. So I'm just trying to...
Oh, Jess. Taste this. Now, MasterChef Australia is back Sunday night at 7:30 here on the 10 and Win Networks. And the season finale is Monday night at 7:30. Very quickly, Tamara, who will win?
Tough call, but... Oh, I don't know. I reckon Diana's got it in the bag. She's been so consistent the whole way through, but any one of them could take it out. It's anyone's game.
You should win with this. I can't believe it.
Thank you.